So as you're watching this, notice the drive has a bit of a wobble in it. And it's happening because the friction disc isn't quite flat, and the O-ring that I have here is a little too tight, so it's kind of stretched out. I can't get it perfectly round. That wobble's kind of limiting the amount of torque that I can get, because where the O-ring's fattest, the pressure's increased, and where it's thinner, there's less friction. So that's limiting the amount of torque. So I'll have to buy some O-rings before I can fix that. Let's see if it'll work at all. Alright, reverse. And forward. And it went right up that slope without a problem, so here's a slightly steeper slope. And it gets stuck right there on the thin point of the O-ring. Just starts slipping. So to make that friction disc, I took two of these discs, sanded them flat, joined them together, and now I'm lapping them to get them flat. That motor can swing up and down freely, so the weight is because the motor is pressing down on the disc. Here's the disc finished after I applied a layer of super glue and some salt to that and lapped it again. So it's a few days later. I got those O-rings, I made another friction disc, and everything is flat and round, and all the tolerances are good, so there's not too much friction, but there's enough pressure, and let's see if it'll get up these slopes here. I kept trying steeper and steeper angles until I got to the point where the tires were slipping, so I guess I would need to make a four-wheel drive vehicle, but I don't really want to do that right now, so we'll call this test concluded. I don't know why you would ever want to use this on a model, but it works. Thanks for watching.